Welcome to Power BI Dashboard Tutorial. Today, we will create a dashboard, using e-commerce data, of customer purchases and interaction. The data has already been uploaded for you on Kaggle. Download the CSV file, and save it in your computer, to follow through the tutorial. You can explore the data in MS Excel. Other than this, you also need four icons, for male, female, desktop, and tablet. You can get them from Microsoft Office, or use any other source you like. First of all, we will use the Get Data button, to open the CSV file in Power BI Desktop. In the preview window, we will press Load, to load the data, into the Power BI Desktop application. The table, and its fields will be loaded in the data pane, which we can use in various visuals. Add a text box to your dashboard, and enter an appropriate title for your dashboard. Turn on visual border of your text box. Add the country field, to your dashboard. This will automatically, add a map chart. Add the sales field, to the bubble size area. Place the map visual, on top left corner. Turn on visual borders of the map visual. You can also change the style of your map visual. Insert an image, and select an icon for computer. Place the image, next to the map visual. Add a card visual to your dashboard. Add the device category field as count. Add the same field, to the filters, and select computer only. Disable the category label from settings. Place the card, below the image appropriately. Add another image with an icon of a tablet, and place it next to the existing one. Copy the card visual, and place it below the image. From Filters, select Mobile, instead of Computer. Add a blank text box to your dashboard, and turn on its visual border. Now, place it around the picture visuals. Make the text box visual completely transparent. Similarly, we will add pictures with male and female icons as well, and place them in the top right corner. Just like before, add a card to your dashboard, with gender field and values, as count. Turn off the category label. Add the gender field to the filters as well. And select male only. Then place the card, below the image with male icon. Now, copy the card, and place it under the image with female icon. And select female from the filters. Finally, copy the text box we used for visual border, and place it around the images with gender icons. Add a donut chart, with device field in both legend and values area. Rename the values field, to transactions. Place the chart in the left corner, and turn on the visual borders. You can use any field in the values area, but make sure it is set to count. Duplicate the donut chart, and place it below the existing chart. Replace the legend field, with the order status field. Again duplicate one of the donut charts, and replace the legend field, with the OS field. Make another copy of donut chart, and replace the legend field, with the traffic source field. Duplicate one of the donut charts, place it in the right corner, and change it into a bar chart. Now, replace the y-axis field, with the delivery rating field. Use the same chart, to display product ratings, by creating a copy, and changing the y-axis to product rating. Add a gauge visual, to display average session duration, on your dashboard. Add the session duration field, to the values area, and set it to average. Add the same field, to the minimum value, as minimum. Again, add the same field, to the maximum area, as maximum. Go to the formatting options, and turn on the visual borders. Finally, add a line and column chart, to your dashboard. Add years from invoice date, to the x-axis. Add the total sales field, to the column y-axis. And the quantity field, to the line y-axis. Our dashboard is now complete. Thanks for watching. We hope you liked our tutorial. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for more insightful tutorials and updates.